just so that we have the products and the
Right.
This is
where I love to
have
that. And then, you know,
I need to put them in a
file.
And then, if we do publish them, this is good. The guy steering the radio.
This one is selling the shirt.
Of a lot of these guys, huh?
Yeah.
That's wonderful.
And then there was
That's great.
There's one that has a really great face on it.
Right.
And it's got a name
just
this one, she reminds me of a woman that has a watch on it.
This is a famous face.
Just for a second. Come on, Ralph, all the way up. There you go. That's good. Well, a small Paul. Smile, Paul. It's almost the end of the day.
Well, that's what I would do, is make Xeroxes.
You have a lot of fun. My name's on all of them.
These are these were all those taken by you.
Yeah. And my name is Julie.
Hi, Julie. I'm my name. So my name is Mariah Brown, and I've been a resident in the Rye Market for a little over a decade or so. I've been living around the area for a while. So,
and are you volunteer or
that's a good way, and then I'll say, gee, what's wrong? And you'll say,
well, I can just maybe wait or something. So, because if I'm trying to sort of ponder something, I'd rather ponder it off camera than on. So let me know when you turn it on.
It's on.
Oh, you should tell me. Can we look at you or the camera?
No, ignore the camera, because that's against.
May not be my best. So.
Well, Pat Belargeon, what is your first name?
My name is Patricia Belargeon.
And you one of how many siblings do you have?
There are five of us.
You were active in civic.
say there were more vegetables and more fruits and more vendors, I think. But, and the market was probably a little shabby and down at the heel more than it is now, probably not quite so much bright paint. But actually, the market, I'm happy to say, wasn't that different in spirit and feeling. I mean, the same sign was up there, the same clock, and lots of the same regular people, and probably not as many tourists. That's but I can remember, and I should look it up, or somebody should, that in the newspaper, when Luke had been elected to the city council for the first time within that year, right after the Seattle World's Fair, and I remember Wang either gave an interview or was caused an art column to be written, an article to be written in either the Seattle PI or the Seattle Times, probably early-ish or mid-63, again we need to check the dates, discussing saving the Pike Place market, that it was just too much of a treasure to lose. And it really was that column that kicked it off. Wang, of course, was up in the council when he wrote it, and the council was involved in debating the future of the area. But
in fact, the council and the city fathers, more or less, had been planning the demise of the market.
And they were planning the demise. And I, again, would need to really do research, or you're doing the research to find out
the dates
by years. But
the attitude and the
The attitude was that it would be better to clean it up and build high rises and things that were going to, you know, all this, that were going to bring wonderful income. And Wing had a wonderful insight into the city, into this city particularly, but into cities, and he's a terribly bright person with a very broad overview of things. And he felt very strongly this was a treasure that could never be replaced, of course. So he was a very good friend of Bob Ashley's, and either he called Bob or Bob called him, but just literally, I'm sure, within hours of that column or that article appearing in the newspaper, and they got their heads together to start Friends of the Market. And whether they called it Friends of the Market in the early discussion, I have no idea, but it evolved into that name. And again, I'd have to look back, I probably could in my own calendars even, but on a winter night, it was a cold night and very rainy, I came up from my office, which was down in the Norton Building, and Wayne and Bob were already at work, and the art stall down right under us here, they had already contacted, Bob, I imagine, had already contacted the Organization of Women Painters. Can you remind me the name of the group?
Well, it's still a cooperative
yes.
of watercolors.
Watercolors, the American watercolors. Yeah. And so they were going to have that open stall, and the reason I remember the time of year, not the month, I'm sorry, but the time of year is because it was cold, and those women were really staffing the first office of Friends of the Market. They had other information there while they sat and sold their cards and their paintings, and that was the very beginning. And that night, I remember Wing and Bob actually nailed it up. They actually got it out the stall, whatever was in it, when they arrived, they rented it, and they actually nailed up what needed to be nailed up and furnished it and got it organized for the women who started within a couple of days.
I wanted to back up a little bit. Wayne Luke died in 1965 in a plane crash with Sid Gerber, a business manager in the Seattle area.
And Kayla did.
Could you tell us more about Wayne Luke, his attachment to the market, and did he grow up here? Did his folks have any connection to it? Did he just see it as an important element of the city?
I think Wayne was such a unique person. He had just an amazing, he was really the first bridge, I think, in this city, certainly in public office, between perhaps Asian culture and Seattle, if you want to call Seattle culture in quotes. I know Wayne spent some years in Canton, where he was born, I'm not sure. I always thought he could be president, so if he was born in Canton, he would have been able to be president.
Canton, Ohio. Maybe he's
I think we're talking about China, but anyway. Wayne's parents were immigrants, and I believe we'd have maybe to interview Betty Kahn, his sister, would be a very good idea. That would be a very good idea.
It's a good lead.
Yeah, very good, because she's very eloquent, and she's certainly very knowledgeable, and she was very close to Wayne and all the things he was involved in. But, so Betty could clarify, but his parents, if I recall, ran a small grocery store. If they had any English, they didn't have much English-speaking ability. Wayne was a terribly bright person and very sensitive to all cultures. I've remember having parties over at Kay's for foreign visitors for the World Affairs Council and foreign students. And he always said he was going to, and he always,